Namaste Dev Sapiens, in this tutorial we are going to continue our space shooter tutorial, and before starting I'm going to show you this cartoon water shader for lightweight render pipeline. So if you're looking for a cartoon water shader, this is a very suitable asset and it's $15 only, so you can buy it and it suits pretty well for that purpose. So now head back to our project. We were creating enemies and health system, and in the earlier part we got to this point. So after that I thought that creating a laser projectile pool for an enemy is going to be very costly for the CPU, because whenever we are spawning an enemy entity, we are also spawning a projectile pool which is currently 5 in size, so we are going to spawn 6 entities at the same time, so it's going to be very performance heavy. So object pooling has a negative effect on performance in that case, so we're only going to use plain instantiate and destroy when we're dealing with projectiles in enemy. So we're going to remove this thing, and we're also going to remove this thing. Now let's head back to our enemy laser script, and I think that we should create a script which is more generalized. That will be enemy projectile script, and we will inherit this script from the enemy projectile script. So let me create that script really fast. I actually already did from the last tutorial, last try, sorry for that. I'm going to delete all of this. So simply we're going to copy all of this, paste it here, and we will say all of these variables should be protected now. Protected. And we're also going to create a new variable. That will be a boolean, and we will say protected bool destroy projectile. So we are creating this variable because when we are having projectiles such as the lightning streaks or something else, that should not destroy even on collision with the player. So for that purpose we are going to create this variable. So only if we can destroy the projectile on collision, we will say else we will return from this update method. In the enemy laser we have to just simply inherit it from the enemy projectile. I guess we don't have to do anything here, so it's completely blank now, and all of these things are here: destroy projectile, time to destroy, damage. Now we're going to code the fire rate and the projectile respawn. Now we're going to code the firing part, so we'll say private void fire. So this will be our fire method. We are going to invoke it. So we are only going to invoke it if projectile to spawn is not equal to null. We'll say invoke repeating. This is our fire method, and we will invoke it in the first frame at this, and then we will invoke it according to our fire rate. So let me create some really quick variables, and that will be our private vector to projectile spawn offset, and we'll say it as 0f minus 1.3f, just quick guesses. And the next thing is our speed of the projectile speed. That will be the force that we're going to apply. We'll say it as new vector 2 0f and minus 1f. We're also going to serialize those two things. Now we're going ahead with the fire function method. We'll say proj is instantiate our projectile to spawn, and now the position, we'll say target position. We're going to create that variable, but the rotation should be projectile to spawn dot transform dot rotation, and the parent should be this transform. So now we're going to instantiate this as a game object, and this is our target pose which is remaining. So I'm going to create this target pose. This will be a new vector too, and we'll say transform.position.x plus spawn offset.x comma transform.position.y plus spawn offset.y. And now we are done instantiating our projectile. So after that we are going to add the add force to it. So we are going to add force only if we get a component that will be a rigid body 2D. So we're only going to add force then. So let me copy this, and we will say dot add force, and the force is our projectile speed, and the force mode will be our impulse mode, or maybe we can, yes, there are only two modes. So we are all done for now. I guess we should move to Unity now. So let's create enemy really quick. So I guess this is correct. This is appropriate for enemy. So place it here. Rotate it 180 in the X, Z axis. Let me scale it to 1.5. And we are going to add enemy script to it. So enemy is also going to have an health, so we are also going to add the health component. And the projectile to spawn, you can see all of these variables. I guess the fire rate should be something high because I have tested earlier and 0.3 doesn't stand. Okay, so in the prefabs we have this player laser. We are going to duplicate this prefab and send it to enemies folder, and we're going to change the name to enemy laser and change the sprite to this one. I guess that's okay by now. Let me drag it. Yes, and we're going to add this, remove this enemy script laser script, and we're going to add enemy laser script here. So these things all real quick, and this rename it our enemy. This is the layer of enemy. This is the enemy projectile layer. So I guess that should work now. You can see it works. Oh, what is that? Wait. A player controller, shoot laser, player missile, player laser one. This is the laser, this is the player projectile. What is happening? This is, I didn't do that. I never. Only this and let me see. Wait for a second. This is our player laser pool. Laser blue, all of them are blue. Nah. So why is this thing happening? Oh my god. Something terrible. Let me see. Oh yes. This thing right here, we have to say destroy game object because we're no longer using a projectile pool and we're just saying player controller dot instance dot release laser. So it was kind of very messy. We were adding this enemy projectile to our object player laser pool. Now we have it, guys. You can see. So now we are going to add the collision part and the health, not the health, the damage. So you can see our player doesn't have a collider and a rigid body and so for the enemy. So let's do some things real quick. you're going to add rigid body 2D component, we're going to add box collider 2D component, and we're going to rescale it something like this, and same for it. This is dynamic gravity scale. Let's set it to 0. And I guess we should make it kinematic. This to kinematic. So now see what happens. You can see the laser collide. Okay. You can see the laser collide. We can't collide with the enemy, but this laser collides with it. We can't collide with our own laser. It collides with them. So the player can also collide with enemy. We have to keep that in mind. This is player, this is enemy. Yes, the player can collide with the enemy. Let me check. This is the enemy. And this is player. Seems like we can't. Yes, this is kind of kinematic. If we set it to dynamic, let me see. Yes, you can see. Okay. So now, let me guess what we are going to do next. We are going to do the damage thing here. So on collision enter, we are only going to say we are only checking collided, and same for the player laser, we are only checking collided. But we have to check if what laser we layer we collided with, we are going to give it a certain damage, and we also have to add this damage amount here. And we'll say player cause a damage of 25. Okay, so collided true. Then we will say if collision dot game object dot, how can we check the layer? Yes. Oh, we will only say if that get component enemy. Okay, then we will say no enemy, we will only say health. That's our master plan. We will say dot decrease health by 25. Okay, and not 25 the damage, the same thing for that, our enemy projectile. Okay, so now you have it guys, and we also have to destroy it on collision, so we will destroy it after that. Destroy game object. And this is destroyed, and in this we'll release this laser. The same thing for the missile, because I'm not using projectile there. Explosion effect, the damage is going to be very severely high here. Private int damage, let's set it to 70. No, 100. It destroys the enemy at once. On collision enter 2D, this is the explosion effect, this is the thing, and now this comes, this whole code, say dot release missile. Okay, I guess it's fine by now, and now in the health script, if the health is below our minimum health or it touches our minimum health, then we have to destroy our game object. So we'll say if here. If current health is less than equal to minimum health, we'll say kill, and we're going to create a private void kill. Here we're going to destroy here we're going to destroy our game object. I guess that's fine, and we are also going to check that in update, private void update. If okay, so that will work by now. Let's see who gets killed first. So this, yes, you can see our enemy got killed, and my health is currently, let me see, my health is currently 80, and I was on a very good score. So I guess that's all for this video, guys. We have created health, we have created damage system, we have created an enemy, and in the upcoming parts we're going to create an enemy wave, and then we're going to create an health bar, which is very important, and after that we're going to clean up the UI and maybe make it a little bit prettier, because you can see it's kind of very messy right now. So we have got big plans for future. So bye bye, take care, peace.